observational interior pieces, which are drawings, illustrations, or sculptures created from real-life places, are considered by many schools to be one of the most important works to have in your art portfolio. Making observational interior pieces for your art portfolio demonstrates a level of mastery of fundamental art skills. Interior pieces are usually renderings of interior spaces, furniture, and objects, and often include portraits and/or still life arrangements. Interior pieces illustrate the three-dimensional qualities of the subject matter, including texture, pattern, material, reflection, shade, and shadow. And the appearance of objects or scenes is determined by their relative distance and positions to one another. You can visually explore all the elements of the space you've chosen by taking the time to really appreciate the details of the space by drawing them first in your sketchbook. This is the time to sketch out different ideas for how you'll make your interior work original and authentically your own. It's a good idea to make several sketches of the same space from different angles. Once the space is determined, you can choose to introduce imaginary elements into the composition if you'd like. You can also do a close-up of interior spaces. Once you've chosen the best composition from your sketches and decided if you'll add imaginary elements, then you can choose the materials you'll use and the color scheme. You can also decide if the final art portfolio piece will be three-dimensional and develop details and decide on the medium, still looking at concepts and principles of visual organization, color, and design. There are a wide range of materials that you can use depending on your purpose and level of expertise. The basic and most commonly used base material for an interior model is foam board. White foam boards come in multiple thicknesses. These solid boards can be used as a base for models. You can also use them to construct the walls. Foam sheets are flexible, but not easily breakable. They come in colors and are thin and can be cut easily with scissors. Wood can also be used for the model, especially balsa wood, which can be cut easily and painted. Wooden boards can also be used as a base for the heavier models. Balsa strips can be used for structures to make a wooden skeleton. After you have built the base structure, you can add any materials that you like different papers, wires, photographs, paper mache, or clay. If you struggle with hand rendering or construction and want to master interior sketching and perspective drawing, Ashcan's portfolio prep classes are a great place to start. We have online classes now, so no matter where you are, you can develop your skills and ideas with the guidance of our outstanding teachers and programs.